salary scales or salary of a security guard in Qatar. And actually, for the salary, guys, thank you for coming back to my channel. I'm Mix from the Mix Creation TV. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. Press that red notification bell. You'll always be the first to know when I upload a new video. Thank you so much for coming back to my channel. But if you're new here, please consider subscribing. Bless the Lord to 1,000 subscribers. Thank you so much for those that have been able to give the comments. I appreciate, and I promise you, I'll always be able to get back to you as soon as possible. Now, in today's video, we are looking at frequently that has been a question that has been asked in the comment section. And every single day, at least, I have to get one comment that is regarding the salary scales or salary of a security guard in Qatar. And actually, for the salary in Qatar, most of you, you'll bear with me, or most of you, you know the actual rules that we are supposed to follow as we get salary, and those that are set by the government. But I'll give you my own experience. I'll give you a little bit of my own experience in one way or the other. Maybe you can try to figure out, you can have to get that between those range, and they can give you exactly what you work for, especially for a given salary at one moment of time, in case you are recruited to go on, you're recruited to work as a security guard. And my own experience before, when I was a security guard, it was something very different away with what is actually right now. But remember, a person working in Qatar as a security guard typically earns between 4,560, that is per month, as salary, depending on your position. And salaries are ranging between 2,310 to almost around 620. That is the highest amount of salary a security guard earns in Qatar. And this typical average, we are looking at the average monthly salary that includes housing, transport, and other benefits that a person gets from Qatar in from the job or from his position at that time. And remember, the different job positions that are given different salary scale. So that one, as you're looking at salaries, if you're definitely looking at salaries, you should have that in mind, that the different positions. Now, which kind of position you're looking for? A security guard, a security officer, X-ray operator, a supervisor, a team leader, patrolling supervisor, a safety supervisor, senior supervisor. Those are all different positions in the security department, especially in the private companies. And each of those parts that I'm trying to mention, one or the other, they get different amounts of money, or they get different amounts of salary according to the position they have to hold at a different rate. But remember, when we are actually talking about salary, when we are talking about salary, especially in the Gulf, I'll say in the Gulf or in the Gulf countries. When I talk about the Gulf countries, I mean UAE, I mean Oman, I mean Qatar, I mean Bahrain, I mean Saudi Arabia, I mean Kuwait, I mean Qatar. And this is exactly almost getting a little bit similar, that the roles of a security guard in all the Gulf countries is almost similar. Although there may just be a difference in salary payment skills as per a different country, but the roles are different in one way or the other. But when we look at in salary, for example, right now, someone was asking me a lot of questions about salary scale in Qatar, and we know that 22 is just the lead to World Cup, and there are a lot of opportunities, of the job opportunities that will be there, for example, in the security department, because they will need guards to go in to have the accommodations, the football accommodations, we have stadiums. So probably we anticipate that by 2022 the opportunities will always be there for security guards. But again, that does not stop you, that you can have an insight into the salary of what you expect at the range. Remember, I told you one thing, and I told you that now when we're being recruited, or when people are being recruited by recruitment companies, they normally get a different figure and a different figure. But this, as we try to discuss right now, it will just help you to know that if you're being recruited by any recruitment agency or recruitment company or manpower agency in your country, in case you are to do that, then you know the salary scale ranging in what range. If it fit for you, then probably you can take up the role at one more member. But remember, something that I have to remind you, that the basic salary in Qatar is 1,000. No any other company that is going to lie you in any way. The basic salary for all employees in Qatar, including the domestic worker, is at 1,000. So that one should be something, first of all, should be in your heart, should be in your mind, that now my basic salary is going to start from that amount of money at one or another. But before we get into such kind of things, before we get into that, by the way, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Give me a thumbs up if you think this video is very important or is very helpful for you and educative in any way. Give me a thumbs up, share the video, let others know about this, and I'll always be happy if you put a comment in this comment section below, and I'll be able to get back to you as soon as possible. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. We are looking at a road to 1,000 subscribers. Guys, I ask for your support. Thank you so much, guys. I know I will support, and we have the road to 1,000 subscribers. So let's get into deep of the video. Right now, first of all, let us first try to look at the factors that may determine the salary of a security guard of any official in the private company or in Qatar, and what are those factors that you normally based on before you can see the different salary scales or the different salary violations that people have in one way or the other. First of all, we shall start from the recruitment company itself, from your home of country. How definitely you get to negotiate with your contract, that is very important. It's one factor that is going to determine. It's one factor that is going to determine how much salary you are going to get at one or the other. And if you definitely discuss it well, or if you negotiate it well, then probably you will see that yourself you'll have a good salary, or you have a good salary as when you get to come, and that would be your added advantage in one way or the other. Then we see that we also look at a situation whereby the level of the experience in the security department will also, or in the security sector, will also is going to give you an upper hand when they're actually looking at how much is to offer for you, or how much is to offer to you for your employment at one moment of time. Imagine a situation whereby a guard is 1 to 2 years experience. You can't compare the same guy with someone with let's say 3 to 5, 3 to 7 years. So if they're actually looking for a security guard that has the experience in the Gulf, then this one of 3 to 7 years or 3 to 5 years is probably has more experience than this. And when you look at some private companies, we have the private securities. Let's say, for example, you're being hired by a hotel as a private security for that hotel. They will probably look at, when you look at the job description, they will probably look at the number of experience of years that that you have with that company. So as you try so much to talk about how much I'm going to get, and first of all, you also have to look at what kind of experience you really have in that country. We are not looking outside your country. Yes, outside your country may be mandatory for the interview purposes for that matter. But again, we are looking at how much experience do you have in that country regarding security. You know, all different countries have different security procedures, security protocols, and how they probably do, or how they actually mandate carry out their private securities and their activities in one way or the other. You cannot compare the Gulf countries with the Africa Security Guard, where a guard has to to hold a gun, or he has to hold a machine gun, or he has to hold a gun all the time when he's guarding for safety. Here, it's here in the Gulf, when you look at the Gulf countries, it's all about your brain, how your concentration are, and how probably you can give the customer care. That is what normally they so much consider, and how probably you can deal with some kind of tight situations, or how you probably you can handle all the tactical situations at that time, especially when it comes to protecting safety and protecting protecting people and their property. And it is actually all what is needed at that time. So sometimes we should also look at, for example, in the Gulf, they so much also look at the gender. They also look at what we call the gender. When we talk about the gender, oh, definitely, you know, we are talking about the female, the male at that time. And you find that in this situation, the male security guards earn more money compared to the female security guard. One reason I'll give is that the men tend to work more hours than the female, and even the feminine of the men, the women. So that one gives you an upper hand. And when you look at, for example, here in Qatar, is that you find that a man or a male security guard earns 10% increase in the salary compared to the female at that time. So you find that at that time we shall have the different salary violations from all the different groups that will be working in that area. Then you also look at the working time at a given point or at a given location or at a given project. You find that those that are working 12 hours and those that are working 9 hours and those that are working 8 hours. So what does it mean? For someone who is working 8 hours, he's definitely not going to get the same amount of money. The same amount of money with that person who is working 12 hours, meaning that there will be a salary difference at one or the other. So that one also is also another factor that is probably going to explain to you, or is going to explain to you how probably you'll get a higher amount of money compared to other security guards. I can give an example. I can just need to give you an example in one way or the other. And in my own experience, in one way or the other, my contract negotiation was totally different away from what I say. I negotiated it well, and probably when I got to find myself, I had a different amount of money compared to other guards in one way or the other. But that was, I keep on telling, it was how definitely you had to negotiate with the recruitment company, and definitely how you got to negotiate the salary in one way or the other. So that one also gives a difference in one way or difference. And there's some locations that are really very good that even if when you work in 8 hours or 12 hours, you'll expect a lot of money. And that is what actually sometimes happens in different projects, especially in Qatar, in one way or the other. So you find that it gives you that upper hand to have a higher salary at one way or the other. But remember, when we talk about salaries, still when we have to talk about salaries, we don't have to forget, or we don't have to forget to talk about the minimum basic salary that was introduced by the government. Because our all our placements, or all our basing of salary being paid, is just going to start from there. Remember, when we are talking about the basic salary, we are talking about that amount of money, the least amount of money that is a guard or any domestic worker is supposed to pay after offering his service in one or the other. And when you look at Qatar in March 2021, there's a new minimum wage law that was introduced. You all remember the minimum wage law. That was an excitement for all of us, or an excitement for all people, domestic workers especially in Qatar, and whereby the basic salary was increased to 1,000, which actually was very hard and was very good. Meaning that at that time, the basic salary was put to 1,000, food allowance 300, and housing allowance at 500. So whoever had the contract, which was 750 or 500, was elevated to 1,000 basic salary and food allowance, which is 300, and housing accommodation allowance or housing allowance, which is 500,000. But remember, most of the companies and most of the numberers, especially in Qatar, the companies, the private companies, do provide accommodation for them. So that one, you don't so much expect to give you what we call the accommodation allowance. So what is remaining on your table, or what do you have on your table to share it with you, is that you have the basic salary, which is eight hours is 1,000 Qatar riyal. Then you have the food allowance, and also the food allowance will depend in one way or the other. It will actually depend on a given company, and the company has to say, we shall be providing our food for the guards, or we shall be providing food for our people. All the means we are talking about, the three meals that are being given out, we have the breakfast, we have the lunch, then we have the dinner, that are supposed to be the recommended number of meals that are supposed to be given to a security guard or any employer that is being provided with the food at one time. So what does it mean? If you are provided food by your company, that means you're going to get a basic salary of 1,000 if you work 8 hours. And if you are working more than 8 hours, when you are given food and accommodation, then that means a little bit, it will be slightly bigger when they get to add up what we call the overtime. But to remember, still when we talk about overtime is a lot of controversies around airtime, around overtime with the different companies. All different companies have their own way how to calculate overtime at a given range. But to remember, in the overtime that you tend to calculate, or in the overtime that you tend to estimate, remember you have transport, transport time, or the transportation time. If it is from your accommodation to area of work, or from your area of work to accommodation, is 1 hour. That means that if your overtime is 4 hours, then that means you have to get off 1 hour, which is the transportation time to and fro, which is 30 minutes off. So you have, you're left with the overtime, which is 3 hours, that is normally converted or normally computed by your human resource or your company, and the end of it all, you have salary at that time. But also, if you're not given food, then you remember, if you're not given food at one way or the other, you're going to have a basic salary, including the food allowance, which is going to be 1,300. But remember, still something that we need to note, that not all companies provide food for their employees. Why? Because in these companies we have different nationalities all living together. So it may be a little bit very hard for you to prepare cuisines that are going to be accepted or are going to be enjoyed by all the people in the different nationalities. We look at the people coming from the Asia, we look at people coming from Africa, and you find that they have different cuisines preference. So it sometimes comes very hard for companies to give food. So what do? They will probably give you the food allowance, which is 1,300. So what I want to let you know is that Salary in Qatar for security guards ranges between 1,300 to 2,000 to 2,200 or to 2,200. That is the salary of a security guard. I'm looking at the basic salary, 1,000, they start up from the food allowance, that is for 8 hours. Then when you for example, if you have overtime within, depending on the number of hours you work, then it's going to push up to that period, it's going to push up to 2,200. At least maximum, you can have that for that a good company. For the best company, then I think it may be a little bit higher than that. But for a good company, it's just going to be that amount of much that you're going to receive. And remember, this will also depend on the position that you're holding in that company. Let's say I told you a supervisor will a little slightly earn earn more than you or more than the security guard. And definitely another reason when we talk about the different roles that you get to play, let's say for example you are an x-ray operator and then you earn more money than another, you're a patrolling supervisor, you get all those positions are given an increment according to their roles at that time. So I think the right answer for people looking for salary in Qatar or salary of security guards in Qatar, the best answer would be that the salary should be ranging from 1,300 to 2,200 for a security guard, for a startup security guard with an experience of 1 to 1 or an experience of 0 to 2 years. It should be that amount. That, but if you have an experience that is more. But remember, if you've been living in the Gulf for quite a long period of time and you have more experience, especially you've stayed with that company for a longer period of time, let's say for 5 years, they can decide to give you an increment for that. That means your salary will be comparably higher compared to these other fresh people or fresh minds that are coming in the company. So I think that is the right way to discuss the salary in one or the other. By the way, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning to my channel. For anything that you'd like to know, feel free to put a comment in this comment section below. I'll always be very happy and glad to get back to you. By the way, don't forget to subscribe my channel. My name is Max from Max Creation TV. And thank you so much for tuning into my channel. See you once again. Don't forget to watch other videos. See you once again.